Hi, my name is Jamie Marsland, and I have some serious announcements for you, starting with why you're seeing my face on the WordPress.com YouTube channel. I'm the founder of Poodle Press, a company where we eat, sleep, and breathe WordPress. I've personally trained thousands of people on WordPress over the past 10 years and also on my YouTube channel. The first bit of news is that I'm thrilled to say that I've partnered with WordPress.com to produce a series of videos called Build and Beyond, which are designed specifically to help you push the boundaries of what's possible with your own websites. I've also been given a sneak peek of some really cool stuff that WordPress.com are developing for you right now, and I'm going to show you some of that as part of the series. But enough about me, let's dive into the video. 2024 is shaping up to be one of the most exciting years ever for WordPress development, including mega menus, pattern overrides, collaboration, the interactive API, native support for custom fields, and data liberation. And in today's video, I'm going to give you a sneak peek on all these incredible features that are coming soon. WordPress 6.5 is going to be released on the 26th of March 2024, and one of the features in that is you're going to be able to add any blocks within the navigation block, opening up the possibility of cool mega menus. Next up is what I think is one of the most important changes to ever happen to WordPress, and those are block pattern overrides. Let me explain. So at the moment, what you can do with block patterns is you can create a central design, create it once, and then you can use that same design on 1,000 pages if you want to. But what you can do with block patterns, which is really cool, is you can make changes. So on particular pages, you might be able to change the price, for example, in this case, $5, $10, and $20 for each of those particular pages. But coming in WordPress 6.5, you're going to be able to make changes to the actual design of your central template and have that filtered down to all these pages, but maintain the text that you've put in on the local pages. So imagine on your own sites, if you'd created a call to action that wasn't converting, you could change the photography on the central block pattern. I've added a little hat here, and that would automatically filter down to all the instances where that block pattern had been used, maybe 1,000 pages, but all the text that you'd put into those pages wouldn't change at all. So you have this fantastic combination of central control over your designs, being able to locally update those designs, but also filter down any changes you make to the central block pattern. I'm going to be doing a deep dive into block pattern overrides in the next couple of weeks, so hit subscribe down below if you want to see that video. Coming in WordPress 6.5 is the Block Bindings API, which paves the way for native support for custom fields in Gutenberg. And here's Matthias Ventura, the lead architect of the Gutenberg project, talking about what we can expect in 2024.
This has been the UI for custom fields for years now in WordPress. What we're going to have now is the ability to connect blocks to custom fields without having to create custom blocks. So essentially, you can insert a heading or a paragraph and say, I want this to come from this other custom field. So then this becomes the, again, it's just a regular core block. The interactions for the user are extremely intuitive, but it's coming from this separate data field. It's not serialized back to the HTML. So this is a way to bridge the worlds between custom fields, which are very developer-friendly, and blocks, which are very user-friendly. So we're trying to make these like the best of both worlds.
We're also going to see the start of the collaboration project in 2024, which means multiple people can work on the same content at the same time in their WordPress site. Again, here's Matthias to talk about where we're at.
We do have an actual working prototype of real-time collaboration in the editor. It's a pretty interesting flow because it's doing some peer-to-peer. It's establishing a sync engine into WordPress so you can have this side-by-side. And as you're seeing, like again, you update an image, it gets reflected for everyone on the session as soon as it gets updated.
Next up is a subject incredibly close to my heart, and that is data liberation. This is how we make it easier to get content in and out of WordPress. But here's Matt Mullenweg, the co-founder of WordPress, to tell us all about it.
It's something I'm very, very excited about. Next year, we're working on, we're calling it data liberation front. One reason I think proprietary services have gotten a lot more popular. Mm-hmm. Is they do subtle things to lock people in. Remember we talked about the messaging earlier?
Yep.
And some of the CMS spaces like Wix don't even provide an export. Mm-hmm. So they really, it's like a Roach Motel. You check in, you can't check out. So what we're doing with this data liberation front is creating an open source directory that provides two-way like import of all this data. So whether that's in an e-commerce, in another page builder, because there's all these different page builders for WordPress besides Gutenberg, mm-hmm. everything. And then once it's in WordPress, you can get it into anything else that you want because mm-hmm. WordPress is kind of universally supported our formats. We're also improving the WordPress to WordPress migration format. So we have an export, but it actually isn't great in that, like, it doesn't, moving the files and the plugins and everything is still a pain in the butt. So we're going to make that really, really easy. And so my hope is by like radically lowering the friction, it'll help make the web kind of force everything to be a bit more open.
Hmm. Data liberation front. Catchy name.
Also coming in 2024 is the Interactive API. This gives developers a standard way to create more engaging interactions on WordPress websites. Interactivity on websites can range from simple button clicks that reveal more content to complex animations that engage users. We've got some amazing content planned for the WordPress.com channel over the next couple of months, so hit subscribe if you want to see that. Also, if you could hit the like button, I'd really, really appreciate it because it really helps spread the word of WordPress. Thanks for watching, keep well, and I'll see you soon. Bye for now.